so funny. Is it just before I go? I just wanted to quickly explain you guys how funny it really is. Because obviously, if you just hear about it, it seems so funny. So I fell in love with somebody who I really call, really actually loved me when I was 16 years old. But I'd been countrylined and trafficked halfway across the country, so I was noticeably damaged, and I damaged him. He didn't want to date me, which is understandable. So I cheated on him with another person. I don't really know if it counts as cheating because we were only like dating, and yeah, but still, I started seeing my best friend, which is probably why I got all of this bad karma in the first place. And then I'd done drugs for the first time in my life, and then I tried to kill myself for the 56th time in 1 year. So I got admitted into a hospital where I was told that I couldn't go home because I couldn't go back to live with my family. Because they're so abusive and nasty to me, so I had to go and live somewhere else. And that was when I was told that I couldn't again go live back with my family. So I was looking at moving in by myself, where Mr. Perfect comes along, right? He wasn't even nearly, like, nearly Mr. Perfect, but at the time I didn't know it was too good to be true. I just saw like dreadlocks and a smile, and I was like, wow, it's my Mr. Perfect. So yeah, I had no idea he was gay. No idea. Not even in the slightest. I didn't even, not even like part of me even thought that that could be a possibility. I was literally just. Anyway, I have my children. I go on the most beautiful holidays. And then he tries to beat me to death because I don't have a cock in between my legs. Literally. That's the only reason why, because I was a bit upset and a bit jealous because he kept going out and spending more time and having sex with other men in forests and spending time with me when I was pregnant with his son. So one time he stole off, well, he took something off my kit, off my side, because he'd just stolen money from me to give to his best friend who he was in a gay relationship with. I decided to try and ask for it back, which is when he threw me across the other side of the room, smashed my head repeatedly on the door. This was after he held me captive with an iron bar when I was trying to take our son to the hospital because his umbilical cord was bleeding and had fallen off early. So as he beat me, my life went completely black. I just screamed, "Mom, Mom, please help," because my vision went completely blurry. I couldn't see anything anymore. I couldn't. All I could see was like a fountain of lights in my head, cascading around me. The way I explain it is, it was like a waterfall. It went from my butt out of my head and all the way back into my butt, and it just kept going over and over again as he smashed my head. Thought that there was something wrong with me for so long. The longest of times I tried to fix myself, because every time he saw me he would tell me my boobs weren't big enough or something like that, and I genuinely tried to actually grow my boobies. I know that sounds so stupid, but I tried to change the way that I looked to fit into his appearance. And he was still so cruel and so nasty to me, because he's a narcissist. Even after he damaged my whole home, bust out all my windows, bust out all my lights. I don't have a light in any of my rooms. I literally just have to sit here like a slave. That room has no light. The reflection you can see is from the light in this room. And every night, I jolt and I flinch and I don't sleep, because I'm so scared that someone's gonna jump in through my window. I don't sleep when I go to other people's houses, because I'm too busy trying to think of ways to get my babies back to me. And I know it doesn't necessarily make logical sense staying up all night. I've literally just laid there in bed for an hour, and I do this all the time, just laying in bed, hoping, praying to God that I can just fall asleep. And that's where my point was getting. I don't go to sleep until the seizures stop. And the seizures were caused by having my head smashed into a wall, because I didn't have the right body parts. I didn't ask to be born a woman. My whole life I wanted to be a man. I don't want to be transgender. I don't agree with I just wanted to feel like I fit in somewhere, which is why I always hung around with all the guys. But then, when I got into a relationship, he told me I couldn't hang around with the guys anymore because he called me a slag. So I had to watch him hang around with all the girls, whilst being trapped out in the cold on New Year's Eve and Christmas days, watching everybody party and celebrate while I was sick. So excuse me when I say I don't want to be alive, because what it really is there to live for. I never asked for this. I didn't ask to be born into a family that didn't want me because of my skin colour. Because I know all of the Europeans in my family are racist. And I was a girl, so that automatically means that I don't get the same love as my father could give to me if I was a son. I didn't ask to fall in love with a gay man who's so in love with a band that I literally couldn't, like, even if I stopped existing it wouldn't matter. I was just a bit to cover up for the fact that he was wanting to be in a gay relationship with this band the whole time. And the lead singer of that band used me and played me because he wanted to be in a gay relationship with my children's father. Yeah, laugh, sit behind that computer screen and laugh at me. at the end of the day. I'm strong. I've got real strength. I've had to sit there and watch my children scream. I had to kiss my son on the head, not knowing if I would ever see him again, and goodbye to him, while my boyfriend lay in the other room being beaten and trampled on by police truncheons. After my front door had been smashed out. After, during the whole pregnancy, being threatened that my house was going to get robbed, to let me, not my house was going to get robbed, but that I was going to have someone break in while I was pregnant and try and kill me. I'm not scared about that, but I'm so scared to the point where I can't sleep at night because people have broken into my house. My ex broke into my house. Last night I saw someone standing outside my house, and so I froze. I stopped what I was doing. I was recording a track on my computer, and I just froze, and I sat there in the same position for over 40 minutes because I was so scared that someone was about to jump in my window, kidnap me, abduct me, kill me. And if that was to happen right now, there would be absolutely nothing I could do about it because I've got no phone to call for help. I feel safer when I'm on the streets, when there are people trying to gangbang me and rape me, than I do inside my own home, because my neighbour downstairs is trying to kill me on a constant basis. Every time I start to slip into any kind of sleep, she starts screaming. Banging on my door, banging on my walls, banging on the ceiling. She knows my name, so now she's started shouting my name too. So yeah, it might be real funny to watch into my life and to laugh at me. But I'm a real person, and I have returned all negative intentions to send off.